Peace TV English, the solution for humanity.
Stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the Shayatins. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls. Stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the Shayatins. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. All the praise is due to Allah, and I bear witness that there is no God worthy of being worshipped but Allah, and that Muhammad is his last prophet and messenger. May the blessings and peace of Allah be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family, his companions, and those who followed his track and path up to the day of judgment. My dear respected brothers and sisters, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back to a new episode about Healing Hearts. Healing Hearts is a series which tackles the problems that face our hearts, hoping that it will help us to be better qualified to go higher in the grades of blessings and righteousness, to draw ourselves closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to gain His paradise in this life and the hereafter. And in today's session, we are talking about one of the gravest poisons of the heart also, which is the sins, the evil consequences of sins. Some people, when they dare to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or break His orders, or be undutiful to Him, or try to perpetrate some of sins, they don't look at the atrocities and the consequences of those evil sins. Basically, some people, they think that they can disobey once and twice, and then they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The gate of repentance is not closed, actually, until the day of judgment. But this is not a justifiable reason for a person to commit a sin. Because you need actually to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving, and He is merciful and compassionate, but at the same time He is severe in His punishment. And sometimes a person may underestimate the evil effect of a sin, and it may cause him to full destruction. Adam, alayhi salam, peace be upon him, our father, he just ate from the tree, and he doesn't know that the atrocities of that will be getting away or driven away from the Jannah, the Garden of Paradise, and having that until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted his repentance. So a person doesn't care about minor sins, though they may cause and lead to major sins. And the scholars talk about people who don't care about sparkles of fire that may cause a big fire. So some people, they don't care, but the atrocities they feel afterwards. That's why healers of hearts talked about tahliya before tahliya. Tahliya means repentance and purifying yourself before adding righteous and good attributes and characteristics to it. So tahliya means that a person that removes sins from his heart by repentance, and this repentance should be sincere. We will talk about repentance later, but in today's session we are talking about the evil consequences of sins, so that it might be a reminder for a person before daring to commit a sin. On the top of them is a person who dares to commit a sin, he is ultimately deprived of the proper knowledge that draws him closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, simply because the scholar said that Allah filled the heart of a scholar with light. So do not extinguish the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the darkness of sins. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, he is a very well-known scholar of fiqh. He was a young man, and he used actually to memorize 2 pages in just one look at them. He had an extraordinary memory. He can keep a lot of pages and a lot of books by heart. So one day, when he started reading in front of his teacher, Waqi', and he started making mistakes, and he said, "Shakawt ila Waqi'in su'a hifzi." I complained to Waqi' about my bad memory. فَأَرْشَدَنِي إِلَىٰ تَرْكِ الْمَعَاصِ. He guided me to abandon sins. وَأَنْبَأَنِي بِأَنَّ الْعِلْمَ نُورٌ. And he informed me that knowledge is like a light. وَنُورُ اللَّهِ لَا يُهْدَى لِعَاصِ. And the light of Allah is not granted to a disobedient person. So one of the evil consequences of sins is that a sinful person is deprived of the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, he is deprived of a lot of Allah's bounties and provisions that are given to him. This is mentioned in the authentic hadith which is related in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad on the authority of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's narrated that Thawban, may Allah be pleased with him, said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a man may be deprived of a provision because of a sin that he may commit. So a person may be deprived of a son, of a righteous son, may be deprived of a house, may be deprived of a car, may be deprived of a bigger provision because we look at provisions within a narrow eye. Because all of us, we look at provisions in the sense of health and wealth. But provisions are so many. There are a lot of types of provisions. On the top of them is a provision of Iman. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes you a true believer and He saves you from a lot of sins and a lot of problems. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make your life safe and you do not suffer from a disease. When Allah bestows on you complete and intactness of all of your faculties, hearing and sighting, walking and talking freely everywhere. You are free. You are not in prison, you are not. All of those are blessings and provisions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a sin affects the provisions of a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, it causes an alienation between the sinner and his Lord. This alienation is a big problem because when a person have a barrier between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he does not have a better and open way and communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he feels a seclusion. And this sense of alienation cannot be satisfied or quenched by the whole wealth of the world, by the companionship of all people in the world, presidents and ministers, wives and children and all people, even if you accompany the whole world and you don't have a better line of communication with your Lord, make sure that you are alone. You are supportless. You are without an ally, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the ally of the believers. And without Allah, we are nothing. Without having Allah's mercy, we deserve nothing. We are not even a zero, but we are less than that because of the وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ وَرَحْمَتَ. It's only the mercy and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that made you, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Life becomes very difficult for a sinner. A sinful person feels a whole difficulty in every single act that he does. He doesn't find things easy for him. It's so difficult. When he goes here and there, he has a feeling of slackening behind, of laziness. And this is actually for people who have still remnants of life in their hearts. The sin actually darkens the heart, because as it is like the darknesses of the night. The darkness of the sin affects a heart and its darkness and its vision and its obedience and its vigilance and its awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a sinful person is like a person who lives in darknesses after darknesses, like the darknesses of oceans, until when he stretches his hands, he cannot see. Darkness of orientation, because he is not properly guided. He is just following his whims and desires. Darkness in the path that he takes in his practical life, in his decisions that he makes, you find him taking useless decisions here and there, like going in this world like a whirlpool that doesn't stop, and he doesn't know when a whirlpool is working. In old villages, they put an animal and they start hiding the eyes of this animal so it doesn't feel bored and doesn't leave the whirlpool. This is the same for a sinful person who is going around himself aimlessly and he doesn't achieve anything. This is the reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called upon him that he is living in darkness. And this darkness cannot be cleared. The fog cannot be cleared, especially except after repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and referring to him in repentance. These are some of the evil consequences that a sinful can experience, and it puts a layer on a believer's heart, so he is deprived of knowledge. He is deprived of Allah's provisions, sustenance by day and night, and he lives in darkness until he repents to Allah. We will continue explaining the evil consequences of sins after having this short break. So stay with us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Stay away from the sins. Ignore the whispers of the shayateen.
What would you recommend?
Peace TV presents.
What would you have to say about
learning the wise way?
What would you recommend us to take as career
after we pass our school? So what exactly we should do?
What do you have to say about pursuing two fields together?
Ideas brilliant, strategy sustained.
The best profession is a profession of a person who invites people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Avail the opportunity with Dr. Zakir.
Depending upon what is your interest. But the main aim should be to spread the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
To implement the convincing Islamic come educational formula to excel in your career. Watch Career Guidance every Friday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
We are not addicted to dawah. Addiction implies a short-term fix. One doesn't need to get into the zone to talk about Islam. You do dawah because it is a natural result of your commitment to Allah. If you don't talk, people are going to walk. The most effective combination in the propagation of true Islam is found in Dawah Ilallah. Join me, Arib Islam, as we go through Dawah Ilallah only on Peace TV.
Follow the tips to make the task of Dawah result-oriented in Dawah Ilallah next on Peace TV.
Stay away from the nations, ignore the whispers of the shayateen.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and welcome back. So there are a lot of sins, a lot of evil consequences of those sins that strikes believers' heart. On the top of them, that a person is deprived of the acts of worship, because a heart which is full of darkness cannot be properly illuminated and guided to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sin affects actually the degree of worship, the degree of attentiveness of the mind. So a person starts to be far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. he is far away from the help of Allah. He is far away from the righteous. When the sin becomes greater and greater in a person, he turns into a slave to himself, slave to the whims and desires. When he just lives to sin, to make errors and mistakes, this is a catastrophe. Because in this case, he cuts off all the ropes that connects him with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the gravest evils of sins is the hardness of the heart. It causes the heart to die. It's like a rock. Whenever you are alone, you just start making mistakes, start sinning, start making errors with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until the khashiyah, the proper fear and piety of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being diminished, is being cleared away from your heart. And you make him, the look of Allah, is the easiest. Because when somebody opens the door and he finds you making mistakes, you tremble and you shake actually, and you have a lot of stress and depression. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at you, and he definitely looks at you and he observes you, so look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala screened you when you are making sins, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you enough life to repent this sin again. So how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you enough time to contemplate and to return back to him. Also of the evil consequences of sin is a sense of humiliation. Because al-izzah, glory and grace, is granted to the sincere and pure slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the righteous ancestors used to say, Allahumma a'izzani bi ta'atik. O Allah, grant me grace and honor me with your worship. And do not humiliate me with committing sins. Because acts of obedience are a means of honoring a person. When you are being given a promotion to be in a higher status before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so this is better than having a thick layer. And this is also one of the evil consequences of sins, that when a person has a layer that keeps the heart away from sources of guidance, the source of light. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Mutaffifin, كَلَّا بَلْ أَرَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. They have thick layers due to what they have acquired of sins. What is the consequence of having those layers that kept them away? It kept them away from the path of guidance in this life. And it have a worse consequence on the day of judgment, because it will keep them away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will keep them when all the people are going and being vigilant, they will visit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and cite him on the day of judgment and do specific people of sins who have thick layers will be singled out. They will be driven away so that they will be actually kept away from citing the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned to us that the believers will cite Allah on the day of judgment according to the authentic hadith which is mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari, in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appeared to them one day and said, do you have doubt of citing the moon in the midst of the month without having the sky cloudy? They said, no, we don't have any doubt or any problem. And he said, do you have a problem of sighting the sun without having clouds? And he said, no, we don't have any problem. And he said, إِنَّكُمْ سَتَرَوْنَ رَبَّكُمْ. You are going to sight your Lord exactly as you see the sun and the moon. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide us with sighting and seeing him and visiting him on Fridays, as it is related to us according to the authentic hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the people of Jannah will visit the Lord on Fridays. That's why one of the evil sins is not only to make a barrier between you and Allah in the hereafter, but also it will make a barrier between you and your beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. According to the authentic hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the companions immediately before his death, and he said, I wish to see my brothers. And the Sahaba, the companions, said to him, O Messenger of Allah, we are not your brothers. He said, no, you are my companions. My brothers are those who haven't come yet, and I haven't seen them yet. And they said, they were amazed, how are you going to recognize your brothers that you haven't seen before? And he said, you imagine a man who has some dark, black horses mingled with white, brilliant horses. Should he recognize his horses? They said, definitely he will, because his horses are actually white, brilliant white, and they are mingled with the black. And he said, such is the case of the believers, that I will recognize them out of the traces of ablution, of the effects of ablution. And then they will be gathered on my al-hawd, my basin, al-kawthar. But I will find the angels driving specific people away from my hawd. I'm telling them to draw themselves to come closer, but the angels are driving them away. And I said, why you are driving them away? They are my brothers. They are my followers. They are believers. They are Muslims. They accepted my religion after my death. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is amazed. How should the angels drive those people away? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is listening to the angels, and they say, you don't know what they did after you. They made a lot of innovations. They drove away from your sunnah. So this is their consequence. This is the ultimate consequence, that they should be away from your hawd. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to drink a sip of water from the hawd, the basin of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on the day of judgment, after which we will never experience any thirsty. A day where the people will have a lot of thirst. One of the evil consequences of the sins is a deprivation, or a person is deprived of the ni'am of Allah, the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are being showered upon him by day and night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Whatever you have a blessing in your life, it's just from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all come from Allah. But later, and according to another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ حَسَنَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ. Whatever strikes you, whatever approaches you of the bounties of Allah or the blessings of Allah, is because of Him, the Lord, the Almighty. And whatever befalls you of tribulations and tests and trials is because of yourself. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to another verse, He decrees that وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ, and He forgives so many sins. So just the few amounts of sins that a person commits and Allah holds him accountable for in this life, and He tests and trials him during this life for those sins, they are just few compared to the other sins Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives for the son of Adam. So, in conclusion, we have a lot of evil sins. And on the top of them, a person is deprived of knowledge. A person is deprived of the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person finds alienation between him and Allah. A barrier between him and Allah in the hereafter. A barrier between him and his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hereafter. And a barrier between him and the believers in this life, because it is like a wahsha, it's like a long distance that he cannot cross, especially with the righteous. Because according to the hadith, that if a person enters a masjid, and there are all of them, there are 99 people are believers except a hypocrite, and he is a hypocrite, he will leave the 99 and he will attach himself to hypocrite. Because al-arwahu junudun mujannada, the souls are like recruited soldiers, similar souls gather together, and different souls do not gather together. So these are the basic evil consequences of sins. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the atrocities of sins and to provide us with a sincere and pure repentance and return to his religion and to his obedience. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ وَصَلِّ اللَّهُمَّ عَلَى سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
Stay away, stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the shayateens. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls. Stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the shayateens. Oh Lord, have mercy, on our souls. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls. Have mercy on our souls.
Stay away
from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the shayateens. Oh Lord.
The value of money in the hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu anfiqoo mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya yawmun la bay'un fihi wa la khullatun wa la shafa'ah.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK, B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. Swift BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Faith. Focus on the foundation, because the foundation make us a better Muslim, a stronger Muslim.
Firmness.
You must love Allah.
And the five pillars.
Declaration of faith. Follow up with the Salah, Zakat, and Saum, Ramadan, Al-Mubarak. Performing Hajj.
Hussein Yi.
The basic foundation of our deen, complete way of life.
Learn to construct your life on the basic foundation of the Deen every Friday at 5:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 11:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV. Peace TV Network, the solution for humanity.